Hey, what's up everybody? Tom here again, playing Kerbal Space Program. Oh man, okay, yeah, we got some cool stuff. And this is the first episode of my Shelter in Space edition. I gave myself a haircut today, so that was pretty exciting, and I think it has like turned out pretty well. I've been playing for months without making a video recently. I was like, maybe there's some like weird part, and I've made a ton of, I think it turned out pretty well. I'm impressed. Interesting SSTOs. Let me know if you need tips. So I'm playing 1.9.1 because I think we're all going to be looking like prisoners of war pretty soon. So this is the DART, smallest SSTO, single stage to orbit that I've ever built. For most of these SSTOs, I'll just prove that they can get into orbit. See the Rapier taking off. Taking off without a problem. Let's turn the lights on just because it's cool. And you'll notice the big deal is that it doesn't have a tail fin. So the gimbal from the engine, you can see the Rapier has a little bit of gimbal. So let's go. I found that for most SSTOs, if you pick up speed in the inner atmosphere and then pitch up to about 30 degrees, like for this guy, it might be a little bit much, but see, we're already going at over 1200 meters per second. It's pretty slick. Yeah, so 1300. I think we're gonna make it into orbit just fine based on the trajectory and speed that we're at right now. So you just saw it cut over, so the Rapier is in closed cycle mode. I'm gonna flip to prograde. So now we're just waiting to get to orbit. Checking out the map view. Our apoapsis is now way higher than we needed to be to get into low carbon orbit. So I cut the engine there. The cool thing in recent versions, many things have been added. So I flip this to maneuver mode. You can see my periapsis is not where it needs to be, and my apoapsis is definitely what I typically target is about above 70,000 kilometers, or 70 kilometers, 70,000 meters. So just for fun, I will add a maneuver to do this very precisely. Let's go for 80,000, that's probably fine. 80,000 meters, 80 kilometers. Warp to next maneuver. What I like to do with most SSTOs is take them into orbit and then try to land them back at the Space Center. 3, 2, 1. And there have been a lot of improvements in the game recently, so if you don't see any red in your burn indicator over here on the right, you know you can make the maneuver. I found that to be fairly accurate recently. You can see that. This is another new feature on the maneuver mode in the bottom left. I actually hit a periapsis of 97,000 meters. So we are orbital and we have enough fuel to make a retrograde burn and try to land at the Space Center, so I'm gonna try to do that now. We're gonna go retrograde. I'm gonna focus on Kerbin by double clicking the planet. You can also burn now when you're in map mode, which is very handy. So props to the dev team for making some nice improvements in recent versions. When you add them all together, they make the game a lot more playable. So I'm focused on Kerbin. My craft is here on the left. There's the DART. And I'm going to try to just watch the... Just watching my fuel, and I'm watching my angle of attack coming in. That might be too far. That's probably... I guesstimate that that is okay. I could either land on the Space Center or the island airfield. Picking up speed, these are the mountains that you want to see when you're coming back, which means like the Space Center is right over the horizon there. So I will speed this up and see if the dart can make it. So we're in closed cycle mode, meaning, okay, now I'm gonna slow down just for a second. We're in closed cycle mode, so I have a bunch of oxidizer remaining and liquid fuel. 65 liquid fuel is what I care about now, because I'm going into the inner atmosphere where I could burn oxidizer and liquid fuel, but I'm just gonna burn liquid fuel using the air breathing mode on the engines. You can see they're on closed cycle now, but I have an action group on 2. So if I hit 2 now, they're air breathing. Heat is picking up on a lot of parts here. I'm gonna flip to radial out just because I'm afraid of blowing up. Let's see, almost lost it. But heat is dissipating and we're slowing down. Gonna go prograde again. That's crazy. So we just like went in and out again. So you can see prograde. I'm gonna go radial out again because I actually don't. We did kind of a skip there. That was really cool. Went down, radial out, picked up my pitch, and I think we increased apoapsis there. So I'm hitting 32,000. So I'm gonna burn off some of this oxidizer to see. This is gonna be a really weird entry. I'm confusing myself. Alright, so the rapier is on. We flipped it to air breathing, flip it back to closed cycle, and then. I'm gonna burn off oxidizer. I wanna have enough liquid fuel remaining. I don't wanna go too far out. So right now you can see, I think we might make a pitch for the island airfield instead of the Space Center at this rate. Flip to radial out. So we're pointing up. This is gonna decrease our forward velocity. Really, I can just pitch down now, speed into the island airfield. I think I'm gonna just take it this way. And I'm not gonna do any saves whatsoever. Just try to launch these things from start to finish on a single go and see how it goes. So I'm gonna let the dart make its way in. Our electric charge is almost gone. I need to switch this to air breathing. The electric charge is important because that's what allows us to keep stability control enabled. I'm gonna hit it as low as I can go. So electricity is still going up. Make a turn and attempt a landing at the island airfield, which I find myself at more often than not. So we are out of electricity now, 25 liquid fuel remaining. Flying at 100 meters per second, I think this is going to be fine. And I can't remember if I have a reaction wheel in the nose cone of this thing, because it is missing its tail fin, and it's still pretty controllable. I can't remember. I don't think I do. So it is really the gimbal from the Rapier engine that gives you yaw control. So pitching left and right, like I'm doing here. Typically you'd go out of control in a flat spin, especially at high speed without any kind of tail fin surface for control. We're going too slow, so I'm gonna pick up just a little bit on the throttle. I want to see my prograde vector come up. On the nav ball, and it is not yet. Come on. That's better. Okay, now it's picking up. It is good. All right. Okay, close enough now that I'm going to drop the landing gear. We're gonna try to land the dart. I'm gonna cut throttle completely. We're coming in at 80 meters per second, which is a little bit fast, and I don't have any chutes on this thing. Okay, pitch up. Hit the brakes. Whoa! All right. We landed. It could have been a smooth landing. My goal here is that the pilot survives, and that was successful. You could see how it could be successful. All right, back to the hangar. Did you know this is a VTOL? Is a pretty fun one. I'm gonna do the V2 model.